A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 6th June, on the front page you have Tamil Nadu students crack NEET code, 49% of the candidates qualify. So Tamil Nadu earlier had apprehensions and was not ready for NEET, but now we see that Tamil Nadu students have done well in NEET. Nalin Khandelwal of Rajasthan emerged as All India topper with 701 score out of 720. So these are the percentage of students qualifying all across the states, major states, you can see. You should know about NEET. NEET is National Eligibility Cum Entrance Test for undergraduate medical and dental courses. Then this is PM to head committee on economic growth. So to address the twin problems of sluggish economic growth and rising unemployment, the government has constituted two cabinet committees to be chaired by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. So this will be 5-member committee on investment and growth, and another committee will be focused on, you know, investments. So this is another 10-member committee focused on employment and skill development. On page 4 you have Seaweed chokes Yamuna as Delhi Jal Board continues to miss deadlines. So as the city waits for government agency to take action, untreated sewage flows into river Yamuna through 22 natural drains, making it a cause of concern now. So this is how Yamuna is getting polluted now. Then on page 5 you have studying olive ridleys. So research center will be set up on Odisha coast. A proposal has been made to establish this permanent research center near the Rishikulya rookery on the Odisha coast to study mass nesting of olive ridleys and the environmental factors related to it. Then on page 9 you have imperative to test all pregnant women for gestational diabetes. So it says this can prevent children from becoming predisposed to diabetes or other non-communicable diseases. So this is a proposal, you can see it has become imperative now. This is according to a paper published in a journal for Association of Physicians of India. So it is very important to test all pregnant women for gestational diabetes. On the editorial page, the first editorial is the healing touch. So this says Sri Lankan leaders must move to end the demonizing of Muslims. So this is regarding how Muslim ministers have resigned, governors have resigned, and there are attacks on Muslim community in Sri Lanka. So this is editorial regarding that. And second editorial is caught napping. So this is regarding how Kerala has to make up for lost focus by acting quickly on the Nipah outbreak. So this is regarding the Nipah virus infection in Kerala, which has been reported now. The lead article, Hindi or English, comparing apples and oranges. So this is regarding the project to remove English from India, which has long been, you know, quite often cropped up. So this, it says, is misplaced and dangerous to development and integration. So we should not try to remove English from India. And this is making sense of Hindutva. So this says the present political moment requires a renewed look at nationalism, communalism and majoritarianism. So what the Hindutva is all about, what is nationalism, the communalism under it and majoritarianism. So that is discussed here. On op-ed page you have needed a solar manufacturing strategy. So this says despite making significant progress in solar power generation, India still relies on China for equipments. So solar panels are still being imported, you know, solar equipments. So a solar manufacturing strategy is required is what this article talks of. On page 12, you have the continuation of the front page news, panel to focus on employment. So 10-member cabinet committee headed by the Prime Minister himself will look at skill development programs. And this is Nirmala Sitharaman to attend G20 meeting in Japan. So this is Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman. She will attend the G20 finance ministers and central bank governors meet in Japan on June 8 and 9. The RBI governor will also participate. And this is Election Commission to review penalty for false claims. So internal discussion on modifying or softening is likely is what Chief Election Commissioner Sunil Arora says. So Election Commission may revisit this rule for prosecution of a voter for making a false complaint of malfunctioning of an electronic voting machine or a VVPAT machine. So this is an important development now. This is regarding Rule 49MA. So a voter who claims EVM or VVPAT machine did not record his or her vote correctly is allowed to cast a test vote under Rule 49MA of the conduct of election rules. But if the voter fails to prove the mismatch, then then poll officials can initiate action under Section 177 of Indian Penal Code against the voter for false submission. So softening of or modifying this penalty is being reviewed by Election Commission, considered by Election Commission. And this is center wants all states to join Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana. So the Chief Minister of Delhi, Orissa and Telangana and West Bengal have been urged to join the central government's flagship health protection scheme, which these states have still not joined. Then on page 13, you have Navy steams ahead with its plans to go green. So measures have been proposed, including use of biodiesel and solar panels in the Navy. Then below you have 10% drop in H-1B visa approvals in 2018. So the aggressive policies of US have seen drop in H-1B visas. A sharp 10% drop has been seen in the financial year 2018. And we know majority of these visas go for high-skilled workers, especially Indian IT professionals. And below you have how a direct benefit transfer scheme broke under the weight of bank charges. So, drain on the money paid to students' account directly has been seen. This is the scheme for transfer of money for school uniforms directly to the accounts opened in the name of the students. So, Maharashtra government has decided to remove the clothing from the list of goods under the scheme now. So, the government has blamed banks for applying various charges on beneficiaries' account, which is making it difficult for them to access the money. So, the minimum balance which is required, all such conditions are a hindrance. Then on international page you have Sudan crackdown toll rises to 101. So there are these peaceful protests going on for civilian government in Sudan. They want a civilian leader to head the council too, but then the military rulers here are not ready to give up, and the peaceful protesters have been, aggressive force has been used against peaceful protesters. And the protesters, you can see the toll has risen to 101 people who have died now. And the militias of the military council are made responsible for the massacre by the protesters. And this is China launches its first sea-based space rocket. So it was fired from a ship in Yellow Sea. So a space rocket launched from ship. So it says China now spends more than Russia and Japan on its civil and military space program. And below you have Hong Kong vigil marks crackdown on Tiananmen Square protests. So tens of thousands joined the somber candlelight vigil in Hong Kong to mark the 30th anniversary of the Tiananmen Square massacre, in which Chinese troops opened fire on protesters there. Then on business page you have ICRA downgrades DHFL's commercial paper to junk status. So this is non-banking finance company Divan Housing Finance Corporation Limited. So a day after the mortgage leader DHFL delayed interest payment to investors for non-convertible debentures, rating agency ICRA downgraded the commercial papers of DHFL to junk grade. So this is another shock in the non-banking finance companies sector, NBFC sector. And this is FPI's pump in record sums of money in April and May. So foreign portfolio investments in the country have recorded high inflows as such. And this is FDI in services sector up 37% in 2018-19. So that was FPI. This is foreign direct investment, long-term investment. So that in services sector has also increased in India. And this is India's services sector growth slips to 12-month low. So this is Nikkei India private sector survey on purchasing on services business activity index. And this shows, you can see a dip in May because of election disruptions too. And this is microfinance to touch 90,000 crore. So total gross loan portfolio stood at 68,789 crore in 2017-18, and now it has reached to has registered more than 30% year-on-year growth, and India's microfinance sector is now at 90,000 crores. And there's no news on the last page. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asha.com. Thank you.